The depths of the ocean are a mysterious, unknown place, shrouded in darkness and pressure. It's not an environment that many dare to explore. But what happens when a submarine is pushed beyond its normal operating limits? When a submarine reaches its crush depth, the consequences can be catastrophic. Today, we take a look at what occurs when a submarine reaches its crush depth, how such an event can change the course of history for people on board, and what happened to the U.S. Navy submarine USS Thresher. Let's dive in. There are, in fact, two distinct crushing depths: the depth at which engineers say it is unsafe to dive, and the depth at which a submarine actually crushes. World War II submarines were given a maximum depth rating, although it was impossible to tell how deep they could actually go. Some of them went much below their maximum safe crush depth and made it back up, maybe damaged, while others never made it to the surface at all. So what happens at the true crush depth? Submarines' exterior, non-watertight hulls are light and give an effective hydrodynamic form. The inner hull, or pressure hull, is responsible for keeping the pressure differential between the interior and exterior constant. Pipes and fittings would fail as the submarine got closer to its crush depth. Instead of slowly seeping in, the water rushes in, either trapping the air within in a bubble at one end of the boat or generating so much heat that the boat implodes and kills everyone inside. Body parts and fuel oil are among the debris that rises to the top. Very chilling. What happens to the crew? The crew of a sub will suffer a range of unpleasant outcomes in the event of an implosion. If a pressure hull implodes at a depth of 2,000 feet, when the air pressure is around 60 atmospheres, the internal pressure will rapidly climb from 14.7 to nearly 875 psi. It would feel like being inside the cylinder of a diesel engine just as the compression stroke begins in the areas of the submarine where large volumes of air are trapped. Everything combustible would go up in flames until a massive wall of water crashed down and put an end to the blaze. Anybody unlucky enough to be still alive would be severely hurt by the water's impact and wouldn't have time to suffer the effects of oxygen poisoning or anything else. Human tissues are mostly fluid-filled, making them difficult to compress. An individual's lungs and sinuses would be crushed instantly, and the tremendous shock would knock them out. Even more dangerous would be the sudden onslaught of water from the ocean, the vessel's bulkheads and decks, as well as the weight and speed with which various pieces of machinery and engines would hurl towards the crew. To put it bluntly, the crew would perish multiple times in the blink of an eye. The story of a U.S. Navy submarine that went too deep. On April 10, 1963, at 9:18 a.m., while conducting deep dive trials southeast of Cape Cod, Massachusetts, the nuclear submarine Thresher sank in 8,400 feet of water, killing all 129 men aboard. Sonar operators aboard the U.S. Navy submarine rescue ship Skylark heard a sound similar to air rushing into an air tank. Thresher had radioed that it was having minor problems 5 minutes before the implosion, followed by a series of jumbled, incoherent transmissions and then complete quiet. A short while afterward, the Thresher began to implode and split apart. The U.S. Navy has concluded that the most likely cause of the accident was the failure of a pipe joint in the seawater system in the engine room, which sprayed seawater onto electronics, causing them to short out and shut down the reactor automatically. Thresher was roughly 1,300 feet deep when the catastrophe occurred. Without its reactor and electricity, the Thresher could not prevent itself from sinking to depths that were 20 to 35% greater than its maximum test depth. Are modern submarines any better than classic ones? Crush depths on German U-boats during World War II typically ranged from 660 to 920 feet. An estimated 1,600 feet is the maximum depth at which modern nuclear attack submarines can be tested. Hence, 2,400 feet is the approximate depth at which they would collapse. Certain military submarines, however, are equipped to dive to depths of 4,200 feet. Torpedo tubes, diesel engine exhaust and air intakes, the periscope, the prop shaft, and many other components require numerous apertures in submarine hulls. A submarine's buoyancy balance is extremely delicate when submerged, and even a small amount of flooding can cause the vessel to collapse. The Bathyscape Trieste descended to a depth of 35,813 feet in the Challenger Deep in the Marianas Trench, which is located a couple of hundred miles east of the Philippines. The depth of the ocean there is 36,200 feet. A depth of this magnitude results in water pressure of over 1,000 atmospheres. The Trieste had a steel hull 5 inches thick and a diameter of 6.5 feet. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more content. Until next time, this is Fleet Files signing off. See you in the next video.